Hello everyone, today I am welcoming you all on the great occasion of National Metallurgist Day, which is usually celebrated on the November 14th of every year. So very first we would like to understand what is metallurgy. So by definition, metallurgy is the science and technology of metal and alloys, where we study the physical and chemical behavior of the metal and alloys. So now we will understand in brief the different classification of metallurgy. So first classification is the physical metallurgy. Another one is mechanical metallurgy, third one is the reactive metallurgy, and the fourth one is the metallurgical thermodynamics and rate kinetics, and the final one is the manufacturing processes. Now we will discuss mainly what is physical metallurgy. So physical metallurgy is basically a branch of metallurgy where we will mainly focusing about the composition, processing, crystal structure, physical property of the material along with the mechanical property of the material. Composition is like we are making an alloy. For example, we have taken the example of suppose magnesium. So here we will add in this particular magnesium metal, for example, zinc or Gd. So these are different elements which we are adding into the magnesium metal, so it become alloy. So it's like a composition of the alloy. Second thing is processing. Processing is like we will process any of the alloy. For example, we have taken the magnesium alloy. We will process it by any of the thermomechanical route like rolling or forging or swaging. So another one is the crystal structure, where we have studied about the in detail about the crystal structure of the alloy or metal. For example, BCC or FEC or SAP, what is the crystal structure of that particular alloy. Next one is the physical property, for example, density of the material. Another one is the mechanical property, where we have studied its mechanical property. For example, yield strength, tensile strength, or fracture toughness or fatigue, different kinds of static and dynamic properties. So these are the different property of the material. For example, we have taken the example of magnesium alloy. Suppose this is the same magnesium alloy which we have going to discuss here. So this is the magnesium alloy. We have processed this magnesium alloy by using the rolling or forging or swaging, different kinds of processing, thermomechanical processing technique. And then followed by we have studied its microstructure and property correlation, where we have basically correlate the different microstructural feature or factor of the alloy and how it influences the mechanical property, such as its yield strength or tensile strength or fracture toughness of the material, which is basically going to use in the real world application. Now we will discuss the another very important classification of metallurgy is mechanical metallurgy, where we are basically study on the behavior and response of metal and alloy to the applied forces. These applied forces is very important terminology here, which can be introduced into the metal and alloy or into its microstructure by means of some of the thermomechanical processing technique, which is basically used to improve the mechanical property of the material. For example, rolling, forging, extrusion, drawing, sheet metals, and forming technique. When these applied forces introduced into the metal, it improves its mechanical property. But when these metals and alloys is applied into the real world applications, so there it experience different kinds of forces during the application, which can be simulated in the lab by using various static and dynamic testings. For example, tensile, fatigue, or creep, or fracture toughness, various kinds of mechanical testing. So these are the applied forces which is introduced into the metal which experiences by the material. Now we will understand the another classification of metallurgy, that is extractive metallurgy, which is the process and methods of extraction of metals from their natural mineral deposits, or we can say it ore. For example, aluminium is extracted from its ore bauxite, or iron or Fe is extracted from the hematite. Now there are three different types of extractive metallurgy. The one is hydrometallurgy, for example, where we will extract the metal from the aqueous solution. For example, zinc is extracted from the aqueous solution. The second extractive metallurgy technique is pyrometallurgy, where we will extract the our metal from the blast furnace, or elevate the temperature of the metal and separate the metal from its ore. For example, iron is separated from the blast furnace at elevated temperature. The third extractive metallurgy technique is known as electrometallurgy, where basically we separate or extract the metal from the electrolysis process. For example, magnesium is separated during the electrolysis process.